Good day, fellow humans. We here are blessed and privileged to examine the Meodred KV in his T-54. We at one point had nicknamed it the Wallowing Biscuit because of its kind of shape, and the stock engine makes it really slow. And that's always awesome for a medium tank to be. Always fantastic to be really slow. You never ever want to be able to flank the enemy or outmaneuver them in a medium tank. That would be a bad idea. Wargaming. I believe this will be one of the next lines I go up myself. I'm just torn between seeing... I haven't heard enough people say enough good things about the Object Tier 10 versus the 62A to really think that the Object will be the one that I get. I believe it'll probably be the 62A. But first, before I do that, I'll probably get the Foch 155, and then they'll nerf it. Apparently the nerf hammer is coming down for the Foch 155. So, we've established ourselves, we're safe, we're good, we aight. Nobody's coming at us yet. It seems as though we have a lot of heavy tanks that are attempting very hard to suicide by going straight up the middle into Sniper Alley. So that's neat. Also, we have a good amount of heavies still camping the base, so that's cool too. So this is pretty much... And a medium that's basically hugging... Yeah, we got a Super P that's hugging the Arty in a very real and annoying way. him. Now, don't get me wrong, this could work. This big push up the middle, it could work. It probably won't. It usually doesn't. 95% of the time, it's suicide. But every now and again, you catch a team completely unaware. Ah, fuck you, Fence! Sneaky. Be a little bit more sneaky than that. More actively sneaky. How interesting. Ooh, somebody got smacked by Artie. I like that. Oh, 10 hit points. Blow me. Oh, you kill, steal, and hack. Uns is a Jagdtiger, ja? Uns IS-3? Now, the advantage our guys in the middle seem to have is that they've gotten underneath the Arty guns. Not really susceptible to damage at that point. Ooh, yeah, that'd be Jagdtiger for you. Now, if I was the crazy one in charge here, I'd drop a bomb right on that IS-3. But that'd put you between the Jagdtiger and a hard place. Oh, the Baraka Prince! Fear the mighty Baraka Prince! For it is mighty. Oh, flank it's back! You! Ring around the rosy. Pocket full of death. Now, as a Jagdtiger driver, I will tell you this is the most frustrating thing in the world. Where your team doesn't play, and the team doesn't know what's going on, and the team doesn't help, and then you're alone! And you can totally hold that flank by yourself, except for you being flank and spanked by one guy. Sucks. Thank you for calling. And now that our heavy tanks have suicided up the middle, They had a good advantage, and they threw it away by not knowing how to play. It's generally the hazard that most teams face, is guys that don't learn their tanks and don't know how to control their tanks. Don't know the strengths or weaknesses of their tanks. They're just, oh, I'm a heavy tank. I can heavy things. I are heavy. Rawr. Now, that M103 may be a problem with 1,000 hit points. And they've got an STI. That's a problem. So, solving the problem. Just solving the problem. Ding! Ding, fries are done. Ding, fries are done. 29 is in the base. That's a weird place for him, because T-29s are generally, you know, heavy tanks, and should probably be used as such. Ooh, put him down. Excuse me, Padme. And we're capturing the base. I'm gonna guess that that's the STI up there at A5. With his 3 kills. And the KV-4 seems to have nothing going on, and the T-29 still in the base. T-29's been camping the base the whole time, is down below 600 hit points. Oh, man. Sorry. I got up really early this morning at about 10:30. So. A 3 in mid help cap. Which one, Captain Language? Defend the cap? Attack the enemy cap? Help me! Oh, look at all these idiots. Help me! I've been sitting at the base the whole time. Help me! I cannot pray. I cannot have praying time. I don't know how to actually play the game. For only having 2 kills, Marriott Mio's had to put on quite the backpack and haul ass around. So the KV-4 and the STI are in our base. Ding, fries are done. Super P is slowly creeping away, or creeping towards us. Dope! This guy's horrible. I'm just gonna skate around giving up side armor. What a jackass. Now, the ultimate question, do we cap or do we go back and kick ass? Do we get back in time to kick any ass? Because they've only got one tank left. We have a T-30 over there. I would hazard a guess that he could probably take care of business. And I do appreciate the fact that Mio's not letting his camo skill slip and is taking cover just in case the worst happens. So, that is how you basically carry a team that is determined to throw its life away. And or camp until the end of time. Well played, base campers. Well played. Let us check out some details, shall we? Alright, so, Mio only sent me one screenshot, but it is kind of the only one you need for this kind of battle. With not a lot of kills, you know, you're not going to get a lot of awards. Maybe a Confederate, but maybe not. The shooting leads me to believe maybe he got a sniper for it, but Mio's already got like 1,000... bajillion sniper award, so it's not anything he's gonna brag about. But 16 for 17 shooting, 15 penetrations, 4 grand damage, that's a hell of a thing, and how to carry.